A graphic of the Perkins logo swoops across the screen, revealing a chapter heading. Spatial relationship and graphic literacy.
Your own relationship to the environment is something that hopefully that instruction starts when kids are really, really little. If they can't figure out where they are in space within their own environment, they're going to have trouble with an awful lot of other academic skills as they go along the way. So understanding where they are in the environment and where things are in relation to them. For instance, we use words like in front of, behind, above, below. If young readers don't, pre-readers, don't learn to do that, don't learn what those concepts are, they're not going to be able to transfer that information to something more representative, more symbolic, like a book and saying, go to the top of the page, go to the bottom of the page. And they certainly are not going to be able to understand graphics and what they represent if they don't have the real concepts.
In a video clip, a teacher and a young boy in a yellow shirt return books to a bookshelf. She asks him to place them in a specific way.
Can you put the book on top of the blue one?
Good job!
Understanding your position in space is definitely involved with having the experiences to do that and some directed activities to do that. Go to the desk that's on your left. Stand behind this chair. Put the book on top of or underneath a table. So actually having those physical experiences and moving within your environment are the prerequisites for being able to do that in an abstract form.
In a video clip, an adolescent boy is working on a geometry problem in math class. In order to solve the problem, he must determine the dimensions of a grid that is represented by a line drawing in his Braille textbook.
Visual learners use information from their visual environment to form lots and lots of concepts. Tactile learners don't depend on that, but they do need to get that information from in other ways. And again, we're talking about having the experience of actually doing that. You can't move on to this is a symbol for the real thing when you don't understand what the real thing is.
In a science classroom, a young woman who is blind is examining the features of a taxidermied duck. With her hands, she explores the body and wings, as well as the head and bill.
And so having students be able to understand that real thing as much as possible. Obviously, you can't be an airplane. There's some concepts that you can't do that way. But having students understand that is just absolutely vital.
Fade to black.